water molecule elimination takes place. I showed in this circle. You also write down in your textbook in this way only. Then it gives the product acrolein. Acrolein, the IUPAC name of acrolein is prop2enol. Prop2enol, that is the acrolein. Okay. So this is very, very important. Potassium bisulfate, instead of potassium bisulfate, we can use even corn sulfuric acid also. Corn sulfuric acid, that is the best dehydrating agent. That also we can use it. Okay. So you remember this one. Either in the potassium bisulfate, otherwise corn sulfuric acid, it gives the same product, that is the acrolein. So dehydration of glycerol is over. Now oxidation of glycerol, very, very important 5-mark question. Otherwise 3-mark also it may be asked, or in 2 marks each one step can be asked. So you write down the summary of the oxidation reaction in this in your textbook itself. That is very, very useful for you to study the oxidation of glycerol. Glycerol in the presence of diluted nitric acid, that means different oxidizing agents are used for the oxidation of glycerol. One is dilute nitric acid. In the presence of dilute nitric acid, glycerol oxidized to form glyceric and tartronic acid. In the presence of corn nitric acid, it gives glyceric acid. In the presence of bismuth nitrate, it gives mesooxalic acid. In the presence of acidified potassium permanganate, it gives oxalic acid. In the presence of periodic acid, otherwise LTA. What is LTA? Lead tetraacetate. It gives the mixture of formic acid and formaldehyde. In the presence of Fenton's reagent. Fenton's reagent is nothing but, again, 1 mark is there. It is the mixture of ferrous sulfate and hydrogen peroxide. Very, very important one word. Fenton's, what is Fenton's reagent? Fenton's reagent, that is the mixture of ferrous sulfate and hydrogen peroxide. In the presence of Fenton's reagent, otherwise bromine water, it gives glycerose. What is glycerose? Glycerose, again, 1 mark is there. Glycerose, that is a mixture of glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. It is a mixture of, here in the point, the point 4, fourth point, otherwise section D, there are two important one words are there. One is, what is Fenton's reagent and what is glycerose. Okay, so you make the summary of the glycerol, oxidation of glycerol, in this way, then only it is very, very easy for you to study and to also remember the product and the oxidizing agent. Okay, now look at the equations. What are the equations are given? See, glycerol, just now I told you there are two primary alcoholic group and one secondary alcoholic group. So primary alcoholic groups are represented as 1 and 1 dash, and secondary alcoholic group is represented by the number 2. So now when it undergoes oxidation, even here I have written Fenton's reagent, because in the first step you can see one is glyceraldehyde and the another one is dihydroxyacetone is formed. What is glycerose? Glycerol. Fenton's reagent, it gives what? Glycerose. Glycerose is what? That is the mixture of glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. So how the glyceraldehyde is formed, you see, only one primary alcoholic group is oxidized to CHO, and secondary as well as one more primary alcoholic group, there is no changes takes place. And dihydroxyacetone, you see, only the secondary alcoholic group it undergoes, it is oxidized, otherwise it undergoes oxidation. And primary alcoholic group, there is no changes takes place, that is dihydroxyacetone. Okay, and the glyceraldehyde and further oxidation. So even the primary alcoholic group, already CHO group is there, that is aldehyde group, and further oxidation it gives COOH group. And next step, the even the second one more primary alcoholic group is oxidized and it gives what? COOH, and this is what? Tartronic acid. These two, glyceric acid and tartronic acid, these two are given, this mixer, these two products are given in the presence of concentrated nitric acid, that already we have discussed now. And then next you see, in the presence of bismuth nitrate, it gives mesooxalic acid. In the presence of the acidified potassium permanganate, it gives oxalic acid, I said. Okay. So this is this summary. Otherwise, this oxidation reactions of glycerol is very, very, very important one. Okay. And in the page number 122, even the uses of methanol, uses of ethanol, and uses of ethylene glycol, uses of glycerol is given. In the uses of the glycol, the TNG, so it is used in the explosive TNG, so trinitroglycerol. So that is very, very important one. Okay, and in the uses of ethanol, so the third one and fourth ones are very, very important. This is used for the preparation of chloroform and iodoform, and in the uses of the glycerol, so that is the second point, manufacturing of cosmetics and transparent soaps, as well as it is used for making the printing and stamp pad and lubricant for watches. Okay, and the last one, it is used in the manufacture like dynamite, explosive substance like dynamite, this is the one word, and cordite, by mixing it with a china clay. Okay, this point is very, very, very important one for the uses of glycerol. That's all.